De La Salle University Das Marinas is located at the heart of Cavite, specifically at Das Marinas Bagumpayan, city of Das Marinas. With the challenges brought about by the COVID pandemic, like other educational institutions, the university shifted to the online platform to be able to provide the same Lasallian quality education. Strict health and safety protocols have been implemented. This left the campus empty, gloomy. The usual student's college life has drastically changed. And we hear you.
Kaya naman, samahan niyo kami sa pag-ikot sa napakaganda nating campus. Welcome to the De La Salle University Das Marinas Campus Tour!
The university has four gates named after the four historical revolutionary groups of the Katipunan. Magdalo, Gate 1. Magpuri, Gate 2. Magdiwang, Gate 3. And Magtagumpay, Gate 4.
Tara, samahan niyo ako.
Bago tayo pumasok sa loob ng campus, siguraduhin nating sumunod sa safety and health protocols ng university. First, the health checklist form must be accomplished, which is available online and at the campus main entrance. While inside the campus, wearing of face mask and face shield and physical distancing are strictly observed. Finally, make sure that you keep your hands clean. Our first stop, Rotunda. So we are now here at the university's Rotunda. Rotunda is considered as the starting point when we enter the main gate of the university. This is where our guests usually wait for the Ikot Lasal jeepney if they prefer to ride than walk inside the campus.
Alam nyo ba na ang campus na ito ay may sukat na 27 hectares!
The whole campus is divided into two areas. The east and the west. De La Salle University Das Marinas for many years is considered the Calabarzon region's premier university until it became globally competitive. It is the university where one experiences God's existence, composed of period-inspired architectural structures in green surroundings. Its unique learning environment offers a relaxing theme park atmosphere with world-class education. A university strengthened by its core values, the spirit of faith, zeal for service, and communion in mission.
As part of its sustainability initiatives, the university uses e-jeepneys as means of transportation within the campus.
Funded and managed by the Parents' Organization of Lasal Cavite, or POLCA, this electronic jeep or Ikot Lasal jeep has been plying the campus since 2009. This transportation is also in support of the university's thrust of conserving the environment, as the campus is also holding the record of being the greenest university in International Green Metric UI.
At eto na nga ang inaabangan ng lahat. Lilibuti natin ang buong campus sakay ng Ikot Lasal.
Makikisuyo nga po ng bayad. Salamat po.
Nag-enjoy ba kayo sa first episode? Today, sigurado akong mas mag-i-enjoy pa kayo. Welcome to Lake Avenue! Before the pandemic, this used to be the busiest area in the university. Nandito tayo sa College of Tourism and Hospitality Management. Ang building na ito ay patterned mula sa Hotel de Oriente, built in 1889, which is considered to be the first premier hotel in the country. Originally named Hotel Nicole, Hotel Rafael has 28 rooms available for booking. It also caters to different functions and events in their Centennial Hall, Salreal Ballroom, CTHM Courtyard, and their different function and meeting rooms.
Welcome to Hotel Rafael. How may I help you, madam?
From the CTHM, we're heading to the Botanical Garden, the university's avenue for scientific research, recreation, education, conservation, and public service. This is also the spot where the botanical bridge called Lumina Bridge can be found. Lumina is of Latin origin, which means bright light. This signifies Lasallian as an epitome of change for the common good, a spark that can become a flame that would help influence others.
When students want to unwind in between classes, they usually stay here at the Botanical Garden. Meron dito mga kubo kung saan pwede mag-relax, at syempre, ang ating bukod-tanging butterfly sanctuary.
Tara, samahan niyo ako.
Doon po tayo sa gitna, lalangoy, ma'am, ha? Marunong po ba kayong lumangoy?
To give us more information about the Botanical Garden, we have the former director of the Environmental Resource Management Center of the university. He is also a member of the Community of Partners in Education for Sustainability for Asia Pacific and is also the current Vice Principal of the DLSU-D High School, Professor Marlon Pareja.
Welcome sa Botanical Garden and Lake Park ng De La Salle University Das Marinas. The Botanical Garden is actually a repository of the many different types of plants in the Philippines. This was established in 2011 as part of the celebration of 100 years of Lasallian presence here in the Philippines. Dito sa Botanical Garden, marami siyang tinatawag na theme section, meaning dito pinipreserve ang iba't ibang uri ng halaman sa iba't ibang lugar sa Pilipinas at the same time, katulad ng mga native at endemic plants sa Pilipinas. Sa likod ko ay ang Lake Park na binubuo ng DLSU-D Lake at kasama dito ang iba't ibang uri ng hayop, halaman, insekto na bumubuo sa ecosystem ng DLSU-D. Ang Botanical Garden at ang Lake Park ay isa lamang sa maliit na bahagi ng 40% ng land area ng DLSU-D na nakalaan para sa greens. Ang DLSU-D ay binubuo, pag binilang natin ang mga puno sa loob ng universidad, ito ay halos nasa 1,400 trees. Majority dito ay mga tinatawag nating native species sa Pilipinas. Kasama rin dito ang halos 35 species ng iba't ibang ibon na nakatira sa university at 12 dito ay endemic lamang sa Pilipinas o matatagpuan lamang sa Pilipinas. At pag nandito kayo sa university, 2 degrees Celsius ang lamig niya, no? Ng temperatura kumpara sa labas ng university. At ito ay dahil sa mga puno at ecosystem na nandito. Noong 2011, binigyan ng award ng Department of Environment and Natural Resources ng DLSU-D to be the most eco-friendly and sustainable university in the Philippines. At simula noong 2013 hanggang sa kasalukuyan, ang DLSU-D ang greenest university in the Philippines based sa UI Green Metric World University Rankings. So, ito ay nagpapatunay lamang ng higpit na commitment ng ating universidad para mapanatili ang kalikasan at higit sa lahat, ito ay ma-incorporate at ma-inculcate sa ating mga estudyante. Dahil ang sustainability at ang pangangalaga sa kalikasan ay isa sa mga pagpapatuloy ng future generations, lalong-lalo na ng mga Lasallian. Kaya kapag kayo ay nandito sa university, nagbibigay ito ng lamig, ganda, at peacefulness sa pag-aaral na nakakatulong sa environment at nakakatulong sa mga mag-aaral.
Let's now get ready to see the Cultural Heritage Complex composed of the Aklatang Emilio Aguinaldo, University Chapel, and Museo de la Sal. Nandito tayo ngayon sa Cultural Heritage Complex na kung saan ang kabuuang disenyo ay hinango sa 19th century architecture. Unahin na nating i-explore ang Aklatang Emilio Aguinaldo.
Welcome to Aklatang Emilio Aguinaldo Information Resource Center. This was established in 1992 and its facade is patterned after Emilio Aguinaldo's shrine in Cavite, Cavite. When it comes to collection, we have available print to online resources. Students and faculty can access our online resources through their university account. During the pandemic, we intensified our communication channel 24/7 via email and social media accounts. If the face-to-face will be allowed next school year, some of our space are converted from discussion room to live space. So, we hope that soon you will be able to visit us here to see what we offer at Aklatang Emilio Aguinaldo.
Mula sa Aklatan, puntahan naman natin ang University Chapel.
Welcome to the De La Salle University Dasmariñas University Chapel. This chapel was inaugurated on September 12, 1999 by the then Most Reverend Bishop Manuel Sobrevinas, D.D., of the Diocese of Imus, as a part of the cultural heritage complex of our university. The facade of this chapel was inspired by Our Lady of the Assumption Parish Church in Maragondon, Cavite, which is a 4-century-old church. Our retablo is inspired by St. Guillermo Parish in Bacolor, Pampanga. The campus ministry is the one in charge of taking care of this chapel. Its vision is a Christian community living out the Lasallian core values of faith, zeal for service, and communion in mission. Its mission is to accompany the DLSU-D community towards an experience of being church. That is why the center of religious services and our worship activities are done here in our university chapel. As a Catholic university, we give prime importance not only to academics, but also to the religious and spiritual formation of our students, faculty, and staff. We look forward to celebrating our liturgical and worship services with you.
Halika, pasok tayo sa museo.
Ayun.
Good morning po. Nandiyan po si Ma'am Cecil.
Ma'am Cecil?
Opo.
Ay, oh, teka. Pasok po, pasok.
Thank Cecil. You po.
Welcome to Museo de la Salle. Museo de la Salle is a lifestyle and decorative arts museum dedicated to the safeguarding of Philippine cultural heritage through education. In this museum, we offer a quick glimpse of Philippine lifestyle through our collection. And we miss having people around who would go around the museum every once in a while. So you may follow us online through our Facebook pages and some of our online activities too. This pandemic, Museo de la Salle converted many of our programs into online, like poetry readings online and poetry workshops online. We even converted several of our collections online by highlighting some of them for many of you to appreciate. Many of our programs are still connected with academe, and we partner continuously with our academic community to continue serving our communities. With this, we look forward to having you back someday when this pandemic is over, so that we can all explore the beauty and the elegance of Museo de la Salle.
Since its conception, the Cultural Heritage Complex Center, which aims to promote cultural, historical, and spiritual awareness, continues hosting religious, artistic, and festive institutional activities even in the time of pandemic through online platform, embodying the theme, sharing the Lasallian mission of Filipino heritage and traditions.
Ngayon, ating sisilipin ang campus dorm. Dito, pihadong mababalik sa alaala mo ang saya ng buhay dormitory. On this side of the campus is the students' dormitory. Tara, puntahan natin!
The De La Salle University Dormitories provides on-campus residents for DLSU-D students a home away from home. It envisions itself to be a safe place where students may experience the Lasallian spirit as they learn the values of love, peace, and unity. For housing facilities, male occupants are housed in 7 of these buildings, namely Akasha, Bagtikan, Kamagong, Katmon, Lawaan, Molave, and Nara. Female occupants stay in a 4-story building with basement named after a flower, which is waling-waling. We're very excited to welcome you here once everything gets back to normal.
Sa pag-ikot sa university, sigurado magugutom kayo. Kaya naman, ang solusyon dyan, just across the dormitory, is the University Food Square. The University Food Square offers variety of meals, from breakfast, lunch, to snacks. Kaya naman, busog-lusog ang ating mga employees at mga estudyante tuwing magsasalo sa mga mesang ito. Pagkatapos namin kayong takamin sa mga paborito niyong pagkain sa Culpy Chicken, Jeffsy's, Ovenmaid at iba pang food shop sa canteen, dadako naman tayo sa Old Administration Building. For a very long time, all key transactions of the university were done at Gregorio Montoya Hall. Since the construction of Ayuntamiento de Gonzales, the building now houses majority of the student organizations. The Old Administration Building, or the Gregoria Montoya Hall, is one of the oldest buildings in the campus. It is also considered as part of the university's milestones that served as the administrator's home for years. At ngayon, puntahan naman natin ang isa sa mga pinaka-iconic na lugar dito sa campus. Tara! Ito ang Batibot! The campus used to have 3 batibot trees. These are the mango trees located at CBAA building, across the old administration building, and the third one beside the university canteen. Resembling the tree in the 1980s children's show Batibot, generations of students call the trees Batibot, in which for many years have served as venue for students to unwind during class breaks or even do their class projects and assignments. The Batibot trees are said to be 40 to 50 years older than the university and have an existing historical marker, officially referring to those trees Batibot, which reminds the university's humble beginnings. And here we are at the College of Education, which is recognized as a Center for Excellence in Teacher Education by the Commission on Higher Education.
Ang susunod naman nating pupuntahan ay ang College of Criminal Justice Education. Sila rin ang namamahala ng DLSU-D Bahay Pag-asa. POCA stands for Parents Organization of Lasalle Cavite. This is an organization composed of parents of DLSU-D students, which is instrumental in the development and implementation of university projects. And this is the office of Parents Organization of Lasalle Cavite, or POLCA. They play a very important role in establishing a good relationship between the university and the parents in achieving the university's academic goals. Near POCA office is the SEAT building, which is under construction and hope to be in full operation as soon as the face-to-face classes start. Good news naman para sa ating mga students and future students. Pag natapos na ang construction na ito, yan ang magiging bagong building ng College of Engineering, Architecture and Technology. Our next stop, CVAA. Ito naman ang College of Business Administration and Accountancy, ang home of the achievers. This is what we've been waiting for. Ang malaman natin kung bakit nga ba hindi lang pang-Olympics kundi pang-Guinness pa ang DLSU-D. Iisa-isahin nating puntahan ang bawat parte ng University Sports Complex. University Sports Complex ay binubuo ng grandstand, Olympic-sized track oval, ugnayang lasal at Olympic-sized swimming pool. Bukod sa sporting events, alam niyo ba na sa field na ito idinaos ang ilan sa mga historical events ng university? Kabilang dito ang Human Lasallian Star Formation at ang Guinness World Record holder na Humans of St. Lasalle na idinaos noong 2019. ating Olympic-sized swimming pool. Bilang bahagi ng curriculum ng physical education, ang swimming ay isa sa mga kursong pinagdaraanan ng mga estudyante. Laugnayang Lasalle is the biggest sports and events venue in the campus. This is where conferences, concerts, general assemblies, as well as commencement exercises are held. Aminin mo, nostalgic kang bigla, di ba? Maalala mo ba naman na minsan ay naging parte ka ng pagbuo ng human formations sa campus spot na ito? Dagdagan pa ng memory ng iyong isang semestring paglangoy sa swimming pool at ang masasayang kaganapan sa ugnayang Lasal. So, next up naman natin ang Retreat and Conference Center.
From the University Sports Complex, kung saan marami tayong kaganapang dinaluhan at nasaksihan, dumako naman tayo sa payapang lugar ng campus, ang Retreat and Conference Center o RCC, kung saan karamihan sa ating mga students and employees ang nabigyan ng pagkakataong magnilay-nilay at maranasan ang iba'yong katahimikan. Ang Serenity sa RCC.
Morning po!
Hello!
Welcome to the DLSU-D Retreat and Conference Center, a house of prayer, spiritual renewal, conferences, and business meetings. This was built to cater primarily the recollection of our students and other spiritual gatherings. It's one venue where the experience of God is lived and shared. The landscape, the chapel, the surroundings, and the nature's view are peaceful and inviting. Even the workshop sheds, the garden, and the gardens are fascinating and captivating to refresh one's mind and meditate. We have assembly hall, corporate hall, and executive hall. Each function hall is equipped with sound system, air conditioning units, and Wi-Fi connection. So right now, the center can accommodate 169 day and overnight guests through our private rooms, cabanas rooms, and dormitories. So it was June 2012 when we started to cater to our second year and third year college students' recollections, also of our high school students. We accommodated successfully numerous big and small events of our students, different colleges, and different units. Also, several international and special events. Once again, Lasallian, welcome to Retreat and Conference Center, and we are looking forward of having you here soon.
nandito naman ang high school complex.
The complex had its groundbreaking ceremony in 2014. It offers senior high school and currently finishing the last batch of its junior high school. It has its own library and a faculty learning studio, which was created for the high school teachers as venue for collaboration as part of their animus strategy. It also has its own bookshop that caters to student supplies needs and a chapel where religious activities of the high school department are held. Kaway-kaway naman sa ating mga alumni dyan. Dahil from high school complex, papasyalan naman natin ang ating alumni building. Ito naman ang Severino de las Alas Hall o kilala rin bilang alumni building. Dito rin matatagpuan ang Teatro Caviteño kung saan ginaganap ang ilan sa mga pagtatanghal ng performing arts group ng university. From meditation at the Retreat and Conference Center, exploring high school complex to alumni building, medyo malayo-layo na rin ang ating narating. Ngunit syempre, di pa lahat natatapos dyan! Mula sa alumni building, dumako na tayo sa pinananabikang East Campus. Unahin na natin ang IT infrastructure ng university na bubungad sa inyo pagpasok pa lang ng Magpuri Gate or gate to entrance ng campus.
So here we are at the Information and Communications Technology Center, where the university website as well as the portal of both employees and students are developed and maintained. The center also provides technical support to the whole community.
The center mainly provides the IT needs of the university, such as information systems, network technical services, and web development. In this time of online learning setup, ICTC prioritizes students and faculty members' needs for technical support. Nandiyan ang ating magigiting na IT specialists na masigasig na umaalalay habang ating binabagtas ang kasalukuyang hinaharap ng pamantasan sa larangan ng online learning.
Wop! Okay, kisabay ng alam po. Mahaba-haba pa yung seservisan ko eh.
Dito.
Thank you!
From technology support needs, dumako naman tayo sa usapang language needs. Pasyalan natin ang ating Language Learning Center o LLC.
Language Learning Center offers language programs for both local and international students.
The center was established in 2000 and basically caters to the English language needs of international students. Competitive and professional language specialists provide students with lessons on grammar, speaking and writing, and see to it that they are ahead whether in school or in the workplace. Nakaka-nosebleed pala talaga ang straight English, ano? Kaya tara, daanan na natin ang La Porteria de San Benildo parking area na nasa tapat lamang ng LLC. Natatandaan niyo pa ba ang area na ito? Sino ba naman ang makakalimot sa isa sa mga lugar na kung saan ginaganap ang mga institutional bazaars? Aminin, laman ka lagi ng bazaar, no? Tag muna si classmate na masarap na bonding sa bazaar o ang kapwa mo naging bazarista. Masarap balik-balikan ang memory ng mga ganitong kaganapan ng usapang bonding. Pero sabi nga nila, kailangan nating mag-move on. Kaya halika, bisitahin natin ang kampo ng malalayang sining. Shout out sa ating liberal arts students dyan!
On this side is Julian Felipe Hall, which houses the College of Liberal Arts and Communication. At sa harap niyan, makikita natin ang mga study shed.
The Julian Felipe Hall is the home of the College of Liberal Arts and Communication. It houses speech laboratories and radio booth ng Green FM, kung saan marami-rami na ring programa ang naisa-ere ng ating CLAC students. Dito rin makikita ang tanghalang Julian Felipe at Bulwagang Jose Baza. Kung preskong study area naman ang hanap, tulad ng West Campus, malulula ka sa dami ng kubo na matatagpuan sa East Campus. Naaalala mo pa ba ang organization recruitment day nyo? Ang saya, no? Yung halos mamilit ka ng estudyante para magpa-member sa org mo? Joke lang! Last but not least, kung merong bookstore ang high school complex sa West, meron din namang bookstore ang East, nakalapit lamang ng JFH building.
If you need to buy school supplies, we have our bookstore inside the campus just across Julian Felipe Hall.
Kumpleto sa school supplies ang bookstore na ito, kaya naman di na kailangan lumabas pa ng campus ang mga estudyante at kaguruan.
Brace yourselves for we'll bring you to the most awaited tour to Ayuntamiento de Gonzales building. But wait, there's more to that. Here are some of the captivating green sceneries of the campus.
As the campus is known for its being the greenest university in the Philippines, as recognized by the UI Green Metric World University Rankings, it is home to various tree species and other flora and fauna. Sama na natin ang iconic Batibo trees na masarap punta-puntahan ng mga estudyante during class breaks. The university undeniably stands out for its abundance of trees, particularly at the Botanical Garden, which served as a living, breathing laboratory for its students, na na-enjoy din ng mga taong bumibisita sa loob ng campus, especially when driving around or simply walking under the canopy of trees. The Tranquil Lake, Lumina Bridge, Butterfly Garden topping Botanical Garden's aesthetic appeal. If you're a nature lover, then DLSU-D is just the right place for you. The university is a living example of a sustainable campus. From the National Bookstore, punta naman tayo sa Paolo Campus Hall o PCH.
Ito naman ang Paolo Campus Hall, isa sa mga buildings ng College of Science and Computer Studies.
The The PCH houses science laboratories, which serve as venue for students' experiments. Mula sa PCH, dumako naman tayo sa Residencia de la Salle. Residencia San Miguel, or also known as Residencia de la Salle, used to be a housing facility for brother aspirants. It also serves as a venue for training, reflection, and formation activities. Next destination is the motor pool. As you enter Gate 4, you will see the university motor pool. Dito makikita ang school vehicles. Aside from serving as parking area of school vehicles, the area is also used for vehicle maintenance and repairs na ginagawa ng ating mga matitikas na driver at mekaniko, nakabilang din sa pool of staff ng pamantasan. So now we're here at the new administration building, Ayuntamiento de Gonzales, where all the key transactions happen, like enrollment, assessment, admissions, and the like. Inaugurated in June 2019 and started operating in the same year, the Ayuntamiento de Gonzales, or the administration building, houses the offices of our key administrators. Dito rin matatagpuan ang mga opisinang involved sa major operations ng pamantasan. Kabilang na riyan ang University Registrar, Center for Admissions and Scholarships, Finance and Accounting, University Advancement, Compliance and Internal Audit, General Services, Human Resource Management and Legal Counsel, and the Marketing Communications Office.
Hello po, pwede po sa aking transfer po?
Finally, we came to an end of an amazing tour. It was a pleasure bringing you all inside the university through this virtual tour. Umaasa po kami at buong pamilya ng DLSU-D na nakapagbigay kami ng saya, nangiti sa puso ng bawat isa na sumama sa amin sa biyaheng ito. Malungkot, masalimuot man ang dala ng pandemya sa atin, lagi lang nating tandaan na pagkatapos ng unos ay maibabalik din sa normal ang lahat. Nananabik kami at buong DLSU-D community sa ating pagsasama-samang muli. Isang mahigpit na yakap po sa inyong lahat. We would also like to thank everyone the DLSU-D community, our external viewers, and our colleagues and their colleges for their generous support all throughout the episodes. Sana po ay nagbigay kasiyahan sa lahat ang DLSU-D Campus Tour. Lagi po nating tatandaan, DLSU-D cares for what matters. Welcome to Academic Year 2021-2022.
Talaga namang napakasayang umikot dito sa loob ng campus. Sa laki nito, di natin alintana ang pagod sa ganda ng makikita at mapupuntahan. Sana nag-enjoy kayo dito sa ating DLSU-D Campus Tour. Salamat! Bye!
Welcome to Hotel Rafael. How may I help you, madam?
Nag-enjoy pa kayo sa bebe?
At ngayon, papasokin natin ang museo.
Ano po yun?
Nandiyan po ba sa
obsesyon? Ano po si Cecil ba?
Ako. Ano, taga lang.
Tras.
Diba?
Diba? Tapos parang nang side yun, doon nakaharap.
Oh, maganda.
Ha 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 ha!